Are you ready to go on a quest?
No. I figured. But we're going anyway.
Yeah, okay, so I've been kind of talking about this on other streams, me wanting to start this game.
Yeah.
Because I want a game that's not going to, for the most part, tear my hair out in frustration. I've kind of mastered this game already. I haven't played it in years, though, so this will be fun. This is now,
from what you've told me, it still sounds very frustrating, though.
You'll see why in a bit. This is Lagoon. I grew up with this game because my grandmother, the dead one.
Yeah.
That came out really wrong. She had an SNES, and she had a lot of games, and this was one of them. And for some reason, this game fascinated me. Like, this is back when I was a kid and I didn't realize what bad games were, ?
Yeah.
And so this game, here, you should watch the intro.
Hey, Zelda.
Literally Zelda. Look at that action pose.
Yeah, it looks like a samurai movie, but with Zelda.
So that's our protagonist right there.
Baby-faced as always.
Yeah.
This is a JRPG, right?
It doesn't use turn-based battle.
Was it made in Japan?
It was made in Japan.
Okay. And all I meant.
It was actually ported from another system. I don't remember which one.
TurboGrafx-16.
Alright.
Not Zelda 2.
And the controller has died.
Oh, is it not the light not on?
No, the light's on. It's just not responding.
Okay, we just set the keys.
Yeah, we did! That's weird. Let's reset the keys. So that's, it just repeats if you don't... So, from the intro, what can you extract?
Try now.
Nope.
No?
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, the window just wasn't focused.
Okay, that makes sense. So I hope you like slot base. This theme, this
slot-based?
It's slot base.
Oh, yeah.
Naysir! That's right, that's us. I've reached you to be the champion of the light.
Holy textures, Batman. What is your face made of, sandpaper?
Now it is time for you to fulfill your destiny!
Oh, okay. Whatever you say, Gandalf the
Listen
Brown.
Listen carefully. The water around Lakeland has recently become muddy.
Oh, no!
It must be the sign of something evil. Welcome to the plot! The water has become dirty, so it's the work of darkness. We got it. That's up
to summon Captain Planet.
The muddy water must have something to do with the demons that are appearing everywhere.
Now, are you sure that's not just you being racist against demons?
It does kind of sound like a coincidence.
It has to do with the white people over yonder.
It's not like. The demons are causing the muddy water. The muddy water is causing the demons.
Yeah.
I want you to find out the cause and bring pure water back to this land.
Okay.
So, that's the plot.
Can I just capture a Suicune? Will that work?
First, you should go to Atland, which you know well. Alright, we're at Atland. We're at land!
Well, that was fast.
Okay. So, this is our main character.
Yeah.
Naysir. He's gonna be useless for reasons that'll come later.
These are very big titles for... No, I was thinking of NES. I guess this is fair size for Super
also,
NES games.
Also, problem number one, X is the talk button.
Yeah?
Not A, not B, X.
That's the one in the middle, isn't it?
Yeah, the one top middle.
I mean I meant the left one.
No, that's why.
Okay.
I'm going by SNES memory rather than what it says on my, Bear seems to be worried about something. I wonder what about. So we gotta go to Atland to fight the demons. Where do you think we should go?
We're in Atland, don't we? Aren't we?
Yeah, we're in Atland.
I don't know, wander around, talk to people?
Yeah.
Isn't that the method in any ever RPG?
Yep, let's go talk to people. How's Matthias?
Who?
I presume that's the old fuck that was like talking to us in the intro.
Oh, okay.
Matthias is a great wizard. You must use magic as well as Matthias. You'll never be a great hero.
We must use Matthias. As well as, like, as good as Matthias uses it.
Yeah.
You must use magic, and also you must use Matthias.
Alright, let's go to the shop. Weapons shop. I'm sorry we're not open yet. God. Okay, that portrait looks pretty good.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's a pretty good portrait.
This is just too early in the morning.
Too early in the morning to sell weapons. So, that's the church. That's actually where we're supposed to go, but I want to kind of explore a little bit. The restaurant. The water from Lagoon Castle makes Lakeland fruitful. If the water becomes dirty, we can't serve good food.
Why do you look so much more realistic than everyone else? Looks like fucking I Love Lucy.
Also, listen to this track. I have no reason. I have no idea why this music plays here and nowhere else. Maybe they wanted the restaurant to be more involved or something.
Sounds like a 50s diner.
What should we do if the well water becomes dirtier and undrinkable? I don't know, purify it.
It's always an option.
So what, it's not like you're forced to drink the dirty water. You can always, like, you know...
Well, I mean, they need water to drink.
Oh, we're at the mayor's house. Did you come to see my husband? He went to the worship site a little while.
Not church.
Not church.
Can't have religion in a Nintendo game.
Not church, worship site. The dialogue is like part of why. Oh, look at the dirty water of Lakeland. Does it look filthy?
Oh my god, it's blue.
No, this actual color is supposed to be clear. Blue is a sign. It's obviously a sign of demons and whatnot.
Yeah. Dirt is blue in this universe.
I mean, how hard is it to make dirty looking water? We'll get to a site which is really ravaged by dirty water. The water looks exactly the fucking same.
Yeah.
Water's been getting muddy lately. That's all these people just... How boring is your town if all you got to talk about is, oh look, the water is muddy. Yeah, you're not open yet. Place. Yep. Place of faith. Not another church, but a place of faith.
Looks like a evil fortune teller.
Yeah, like Baba Yaga. The boogeyman. Alright, let's get on with the plot. We've dallied long enough, and this game is really long. Okay, so this is where we're supposed to go. We're supposed to see the mayor. It's obviously... It's a church, but not.
Yeah.
He's obviously a priest. Who do they think they were fooling? Hey, Naysir. By the way, I just mentioned to the cleric that the water is getting muddy.
The cleric.
The cleric.
Okay.
That makes... That's never happened before. What could be causing this? There's a problem. The man who came out of the cave was hurt badly. Please come right away.
The music's got to have hurt some people's ears.
Yeah. Alright, so here's a kid that was hurt. Demons are in the cave! Alright, okay. we got a plot.
Giles? E-Guile?
Giles. No, he's more E-Honda. He's more useless than Giles. Man's dead. Okay. Go tell the cleric about this. Are you going in there without a weapon? There are demons in there.
You have to go find the Kikiri knife first.
Oh. You know, funny you should mention knife. I'll leave it at that. So we got this epic sounding music for... Oh, this kid survived this horrible combat.
Yeah, are we?
So now we gotta... Go back to see the cleric so he can give us money to buy shit.
Okay.
All in all, if you know what you're doing, this prologue takes about, I'd say, 10, 20 minutes if you're kind of just lazily going through it. Yeah. First time I played this, it took me an hour. Because this game is unforgiving with clues.
So we're a baptized hero. We have the church's full support.
Oh, no. Yeah, in this game, monsters are nothing but evil.
We got the church's full financial support backing us.
Yes. For however good that does. We should all go to the mayor's house to discuss this. Please rescue Giles before it's too late. Okay, so now we gotta go back to the mayor's house.
Okay.
We'll get to see combat in this stream. Don't worry. We'll get to see combat. Oh. You know, it'd be much better if everything was like, okay, so that place with the weapon shop, what's this place? The armor shop. This is where you get your stuff, but we don't actually have money yet, so we can't get it.
Okay. You know what I love? Games that don't scroll the screen until you're at the edge of the screen.
Oh yeah, no! This is kind of bullshit. Like, oh my god. There's a lot of things that happen in this game that make me go, wait, what? Why? Ah, Nasir, you came at just the right time. Wait a second. Alex is the mayor.
Geppetto?
Geppetto.
Mayor Geppetto.
You, the champion of the light, seem to be the only one who can get into the cave.
Okay, so we're an established hero, I guess.
We've done shit off screen to solidify our rep. Please, put these on and get ready to go.
It's actually the sequel to a game that never happened.
Please put these on and get ready to go, and then we get 300 gold. Put these coins on! It's the only way!
It's so a suit of art chainmail out of coins.
This game's dialogue seems like it's somebody halfway translated and went, fuck it. Alright, so now we can buy ourselves some weapons from the armor shop, and not the weapon shop, because they only sell items at the weapon shop.
Oh.
That's a mistake you don't want to make. Alright, so we'll get the short sword.
So what if you spend all of your money and don't get the armor and stuff?
Oh, then you're fucked.
You just have to start the whole game over.
Well, to be fair, it didn't take very long to, like...
No, but...
I don't think you can... To fuck yourself, you'd actually have to go out of your way and get, like, useless items and then armor.
Yeah.
Okay, let's equip them.
Well, I mean, like, what if you went to the weapon store?
You
bought, like, 50 potions and not a weapon.
You can't actually buy 50 potions. You can only ever have one potion in your inventory at a time.
Oh.
Okay, let's just see what's at the quote-unquote weapon shop, just so I can, Alright, weapon shop. You get a healing pot and a shiny stone.
Okay.
And I forget what the shiny stone does. I think it's another healing item.
Pot is short for potion, by the way.
Yeah. I think, because look at how much it costs. It costs only 10 gold.
Yeah.
So, I think, you can skip getting the shield and or the armor. It kind of makes this section of the game a bit harder, but you need the sword.
Yeah.
Alright, you ready to see some combat?
Sure. You sound so enthusiastic.
Good luck! Thank you! Alright, first dungeon, Gold Cave. Okay, so here's our first enemy.
An amoeba?
Yeah, so combat in this game works real time.
Can you pause?
It's like Legend of Zelda.
Yeah.
So how many frames do you think the Legend of Zelda sword is? Like, how big of a hit radius? Like,
I don't know, maybe 10 frames?
10 frames. Alright.
What is this, one?
yeah, look at this!
It's not so much about the frames as how short the weapon is.
Yeah! So, in this game, you kind of have to walk kind of sort of towards the enemy you want to fight and just keep mashing the attack button.
Yeah.
And there's certain points you gotta grind, too. And then the way the levels are designed, they're designed in this maze-like fashion.
Yeah.
So, you kind of get lost, you have to fight all these things.
So, dungeon crawling.
Yes. Fortunately, you can save. So, you see our first two enemies. One is a slime that kind of happens to just come out of the ground. The other are...
Wolves?
More like gargoyles.
Okay.
And the gargoyles kind of move whenever the fuck they want. So,
is that your health? Are you almost out?
Yeah, that's our health. We only have 10 HP. We need to level up. Level 1, EXP, 7 out of 10. So the good thing about having a shield is that it actually does something. If you aren't attacking and you run up to somebody, you can actually just shove them.
Okay, so it is like Zelda 1 shield.
Yeah, well, it's much better. It's actually, ironically, much better than the Zelda 1 shield because... It actually stops people from hurting you as long as you don't swing.
Yeah.
Unless there's a projectile, but this is another
Zelda
way to get...
1 did that too, except when I think when you were moving it didn't work. There's a jump?
Yes!
Okay.
For a stupid reason, but we'll get into that. So the reason... So let's just say the main reason for having to jump right now is some enemies have like projectile attacks, and jumping is the way you avoid them.
Oh, I thought you had to get over muddy water.
We'll get to that. Okay. And then, yep. So our main objective is to find Giles. And where do you think he is? He's injured. I'm going to give you that.
In the boss chamber, somewhere deep in the dungeon?
You think that, but we actually fight the boss of this area after rescuing him.
Okay.
So we gotta, but first we gotta find a healing item to, like,
I mean, that makes logical sense. If he got injured fighting the boss, he'd be dead.
He didn't fight the boss!
Exactly, he never got there. That's why it makes sense.
Okay, so the boss is behind,
Door number one!
Yeah, he's behind this door. We can't actually open it. We gotta get the key for it.
So the boss key?
Yes.
So far you've just described Zelda.
It's a much shittier Zelda. If it was Zelda, I'd be waxing creatures like it's no tomorrow. Here, every encounter has a hit of death.
Yeah?
Because this little weapon is so short.
Is that your weapon the whole game, or do you get better swords?
We get stronger swords.
But not longer?
No, not longer. This stands out as a testament to just how weird this game is that they decided a weapon this short would be like a good... There are alternate methods of attacking.
Yeah.
Which, you know, kind of, sort of help a little bit.
Do the monsters respawn if you leave the screen?
Or? Yes. They respawn when they feel like it.
Ah.
I'm lost. This game is fucking...
You gotta pick a wall to follow.
I guess I do. But I need the healing pot before I go up to rescue Giles, because you can't actually, you won't move without the healing pot.
Huh?
Yeah, you won't get rescued unless I heal him.
Oh, right, you need to give him the potion.
Yes. And I know there's a free one available here somewhere. Although I might just have to leave the... There it is! Healing pot! hey, buddy! Yeah. Well, if the water's muddy, you can't grow that shit anymore. It just gives you bad trips. I mean, bad water's definitely a problem. I know that. I mean, Flint, Michigan has taught me that you can't just leave a fucking bad water problem unchecked.
I learned that from City Skylines.
Oh my god. The water's muddy!
That's not mud!
Wait, that smells a little bit... Oh, what is wrong with you guys? Alright. So as you see, health kind of regenerates if you just stay still.
Oh, no, I didn't see that.
Yeah, So... If you have enough patience, you can just kind of heal anywhere.
So that whole bar is not your maximum HP right now.
No, it's what it will. But it
what
will,
it will be at the end of the game.
Yes.
Okay, that makes more sense. I was wondering why you always had one hit point.
Yeah, did I level up again? I did. Yes, level 3.
Very uneventful level up.
Yeah, you know how some people, you get level up and then it's just like fanfare? This game is like, oh, by the way. Oh, we got a new enemy! Skeletons.
Okay.
These are actually easier to fight because they don't move erratically, they just move towards you.
Yeah.
And I think they got more EXP, so. So this is floor 2 of Gold Cave.
How many floors are there?
3, but the last one doesn't have any enemies.
Ah.
Okay, so. Alright, how many? 51? I'll hit some. I gotta kill everything I see as I get to it. Otherwise, we'll be underleveled for the boss. Boss one of many.
Yeah.
So, I mentioned that there's a speedrun in this game a while back.
Did you?
Yeah, some guys on AGDQ did it.
Okay.
Recently.
Like, God rest them.
And they managed to complete this game in like an hour 30.
Yeah.
Which kind of makes sense. Cause.
But you're gonna top it, right?
No, he would've. He already got Giles and got the fuck out of here. So.
Was he like really underleveled the whole game?
Yes. Because in this game, God. No! Get the fuck away! Okay,
you're gonna
save.
Stun locked.
This game. So if you get hit in this game, you there's no like invincibility frames in this game. So yeah. Once you get hit, you just kind of get knocked back. You can actually get knocked into a wall and just have all your life depleted.
Yeah.
Which you know kind of sucks.
I'd imagine.
So I'm thinking about the character of Nasir. He's kind of speechless for most of this game.
Like many a RPG protagonist.
He speaks sometimes.
Yeah. So he's just shy.
he's just standing there. He's like, hey, Nasir, you think you can go into the cave and rescue this dude? He's like, sure.
Maybe if I have to.
Here's 300 gold. Get yourself a short sword.
He's the fat guy from Office Space.
Milton?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Why don't you move towards me? Okay, I'm just gonna kill you now. Alright, I think this is floor, no.
Floor no.
Oh, here we go. This is floor 3. Now we're at floor 3. So
this is where RPG Maker got their assets.
The assets aren't the best looking, I'll have to admit. I mean,
this looks like it could have been made in RPG Maker. What was the first one? Wasn't that on... That was on PlayStation 1.
The first RPG Maker?
Yeah.
I believe so, before they decided to make it a PC thing.
Yeah.
Look, we're high up in the mountains!
Yep.
Hey, Giles! Nasir, is that you? I'm not seeing an illusion, am I?
I'm a ghost here to haunt you!
Woo! The demons seem to be afraid of the light. Of course they do. They didn't
Evil.
They didn't follow me up here, but I got her. So he's attacked by demons, and rather than going out to the entrance, he decided to climb up to the top.
Wow, I mean, presumably he was closer by the time that he was in serious danger.
I wish I had the healing pot. Do you have it? Yes, I do. I'll take it. It's bitter.
Medicine.
Doesn't hurt so much now. I can't go back to the village alone. Take me home. Don't
leave. This shit's great pain relief.
So now, well, welcome to Escort Quest.
Yeah.
Fortunately, he can't die. Unfortunately, he tends to move at random.
Spyro 2 has an Escort Quest.
Of course it does. How could that game have a fucking Escort Quest? Alright, so... So now we just gotta follow, so we just gotta take him and just kinda...
Good old two-thirds movement speed.
God, there are... Okay, there's a game that I was kinda playing alongside this, and that game was much better because... It was almost like how you had Doofus and Gallant. This game's the Doofus, that other game's the Gallant, and I'll play that eventually.
I don't know what those things are.
You know, Peter and Flynn?
No.
Okay, I'll explain it. If, you know how you have, like, a guy who's, like, supposed to be the idol, and the guy's, basically, follow this guy's lead, don't follow this guy's lead. It's okay. Like, do this, don't do this. Like,
Robbie Rotten versus whoever the hero guy is.
Yeah, like, Robbie Rotten likes cake. Gallant eats, see, look, he just doesn't get,
don't be a Squidward.
I feel bad for Squidward because he likes the clarinet.
Did you see that episode of SpongeBob, the training video?
Oh, no.
It was all about how to be a good employee and not be a Squidward.
Oh, poor Squidward. Look, he just... he
walks on through. He's got his shield up on all sides. At all times.
Yeah.
So you, I take it you can't knife him either.
Oh, I can't hurt him. Like,
it's just a love tap.
Yeah. You can talk to him, though. He says he wants to go home. Oh, man. Just so much, so many enemies.
Yeah.
So...
At least it's less tedious than having to load a turn-based battle system every encounter.
Yeah, that's true. I got 10 gold!
You get 10 gold.
I get 10 gold. I can get another healing pot.
You say they say that like they're giving you a star sticker.
You tried. Daysir just opens up the chest to find a star sticker that says you tried. Like, what is this? What?
You get 10 gold.
Why? Why did... You know what? This is supposed to be a gold cave. Why the fuck are miners just, like, sticking stashed? Is that their fucking drink fund?
Oh, this is supposed to be, like, a mine?
Yeah!
It doesn't look like a mine.
No, it looks like a cave. Looks not even like...
Looks like a constructed dungeon. It's got fucking bricks.
So, you think that the miners just dug too deep and they unleashed demons? It has nothing to do with the dirty water?
Maybe.
The water's got money! Look, there's demons! Like, if you're living in a fantasy land, it's gotta have creatures, right?
Yeah.
Like, it's almost a given that there's monsters. Like, new monsters... That's not a new thing. The water's gotten muddy.
This is the most generic RPG I've seen to date.
It's just like... It has a princess and we're not even introduced to her yet.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, we can't go until the guy catches up with us. Then, oh, now we're gone. Yeah.
Thought they were going to start chasing you down the hallway or something.
No. You're giving this game too much credit. This game can only do very little, and what little it can do involves... jumping, slashing demons, and telling a plot in the most broken way possible.
The most unique thing about this game is the jump feature.
The jump feature! I was, like, surprised, too. I'm like, wait, why does this game have jumping? I found out the reason later, but that just posed a more important question.
Yeah.
Alright. God. Yeah, so... It's not the fact that there's just one big thing, it's just a bunch of little things.
Yeah.
Like, you can't see what's next in front of you until you're, like, halfway down the screen. And then, on top of that, you can't really attack effectively. And then on top of that, you can get stun-locked. And then on top of that, it's just, like, a lot of shit.
Have you ever played or seen footage of 3D Dot Game Heroes?
I have not.
The sword is as big as the screen.
Wow! Really?
So it's exactly the opposite of this.
That's so cool. That's like how people joke about anime having big swords. Like,
it is, yes.
It's just you got this guy wielding a skyscraper. It's great. I have no idea if I'm going the right way or not.
For no particular reason, I'm reminded of Ilek Forest from Gold and Silver.
Oh,
There was a very, very shitty, like, rudimentary escort in that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You had to escort a trainer?
No, a Farfetch'd.
A Farfetch'd?
Yeah.
Wait, are you trying to get it to its, like, mating grounds or something?
No, to its trainer.
Oh. So the Farfetch'd went up to a dead end! So, you were escorting a Farfetch'd to his trainer. Did the Farfetch'd ask you for help?
No.
No?
The trainer asked you to get his Farfetch'd.
Okay, that makes sense. Is that like a Farfetch'd coming to you and is like, get me my trainer? God, the only way to get a Farfetch'd in Pokemon Red, Blue, and you gotta get it from a trainer, and it's useless.
I don't remember if there are any wild Farfetch'd in Gold and Silver. Or if you can also only get the one from Red and Blue.
God, I wish they'd have... Farfetch'd seems like a Pokemon nobody in Pokemon gives a shit about.
Whereas you think it'd be cool to train if you could get your own.
Well, This is a duck with a leak. It's The Last Samurai.
Yeah.
It's my oh god, 128 and I need 70. I need to kill a lot of things if I'm gonna make level 5.
You need to make level 5 before you leave against the boss?
Maybe. Another fucking dead end! Kenshi. Yeah? How do you design levels? I don't know, I study a lot of mazes though. Perfect! The fact there's just no map feature in this game also kind of just...
Well, that would make it rather easy for a dungeon crawler.
Yeah,
kind of defeat the purpose.
We wouldn't want it to be easy now, would we? Fortunately, I'm not, like, going back paths I went before, so this is... Another chest! Hey! What we got here? 20 gold!
That's 10 more than last time!
Like, why bother? Like, there's chests that actually contain useful shit later on, and this one is just like, you have some gold.
It's weird to hear the message take place in the present tense.
You get.
As opposed to you got.
Or maybe this is a gold cave and that's supposed to be me finding, like, gold veins or something.
Just under chests?
I don't know. Alright, and if I go left, that's another dip.
That gargoyle fucked you up.
Yeah, it's fine. I can just heal. And they don't actually deal a whole lot of damage. Amazingly enough. Fortunately, the music isn't annoying enough to be that bad.
Yeah.
Hey, kid, you up here yet? Thank you. He must really be hurt.
Yeah, just limping along.
Yeah.
Missing a leg. The sprite really doesn't do it justice.
So his leg is just a stump, and then he just pours the healing pot all over his, like, stump. He's like, I didn't grow back, I guess I gotta move like this.
It just stopped the bleeding.
Hey, could you find my leg, Naysir, Champion of Light? I'm Naysir, Champion of Light. Here, let me clear out the gargoyles from your gold cave and rescue this, I presume small boy?
He's gotta be an adventurer. No. Obviously a less successful one than Naysir, but...
He doesn't even have a weapon and he's fighting slimes and shit.
No, he made it up to the third floor.
I guess that's moderately impressive.
Because he went in to, like, beat the demons, right?
And they don't actually say why he was in there. He may just be like a worker that just got like lost.
Mm.
Or he could be a kid. There! We've made it out! And we still gotta escort this fuck.
This is a game that likes diagonals.
Yeah, and you can't move diagonally, I don't think. Wait. By the way, I heard about the locked door in the cave. I heard the old woman Faith Healer talk about it. Talk to her if you're interested in it. So long. So that's how we get the key. Not from, like, anywhere in the cave. We gotta go out and, like...
Yeah, that's... Why would we keep the key in the cave? We want to keep that thing locked up. We're gonna protect it here in the village. What are you, stupid?
You know, this is actually the first smart move that they made. It's like...
So we have to go back into the cave and through it to get to that door again.
Fortunately, the door to the boss cave is on floor one. But yeah, I hate the fact that this game isn't streamlined like that.
Don't hit the cuckoo.
No, you can't. Can I help you? I'll get a...
Shiny stone.
I think it's another healing item. I think Y uses them, so I don't want to do that. At least not immediately.
So you said this is a long game. How long do you anticipate this playthrough lasting?
I can beat the gold cave this stream.
I mean this whole playthrough, like beginning to end.
Oh, fuck.
Think it'll be...
Eight streams?
Okay, shorter than Paper Mario. Paper Mario was 16 streams.
Really? You're interested in the door? There's a demon called Samson in there. You know,
his weakness is his hair.
I was gonna make that joke. Samson! Like, you know how you got, like, Japanese games that, like, Matthias and I once locked him in with this key. Take this key if you're confident that you can defeat him.
She's awfully trusting. I guess you've established yourself as a hero of light.
Yeah. Samson became more powerful with the evil water from Lagoon Castle. He's calling demons to the cave. Be careful.
I was gonna say, if you fail and suddenly, you know, he's got the key and everything, he's just gonna come here and destroy shit.
Hey, kid. The old lady faith healer is in this house. Sure, buddy. Dun, dun. Alright, so, say goodbye to Atlan because we're never coming back here.
Okay. Is it gonna be destroyed?
No, something far more stupider. Oh, hey, lady. I saved the kid. It's amazing. Sorry.
No, you go ahead.
Everyone is talking about you in the village. It's amazing you went alone and fought against the demons. Hey, so, I'm the champion of light, but I'm also the... As you can see from the length of my short sword, I am not compensating for anything. No? Okay, bye.
It's one way to phrase it.
As you can see from the length of my sword, I'm not...
So he's the champion of light. This guy's gotta be, like, Gowry, right?
Oh, he's just oblivious to women?
Yeah.
And pretty sure, because there's no love interest in this game.
Yeah. Not even the princess?
No. You're overestimating the usefulness of the princess. I'm a good fighter. Alright. So it was up and to the left, I believe.
Fuck if I know.
That's the spirit! So X talks, that would leave either A or Y to be the item button, so I don't wanna...
You're just gonna, when it comes to the time, you're just gonna mash them and hope for the best.
Yeah. I don't know if I have enough, like, strength to do it, but I should. I was able to beat this boss first try, so...
How far are you leveling? It said 153, right?
Yeah, 153, and gargoyles are...
No.
Oh, sorry. I have to wait for them to fully dissipate from the screen. Two, yeah. So two per kill. This shouldn't take me that long.
Still 15 away.
Yeah. So I need to kill a bit of them.
Eight gargoyles.
Eight, okay. Seven now. I hate the fact that I can get so easily lost, because that means that I gotta just follow the wall and hope for the best.
Yeah. While not being able to see in front of you.
Yeah. I don't know why they decided that was a good idea.
Seems you have the most visibility while walking upward.
Whatever good that is. At least it's a satisfying sound hitting them, kind of. No, not down there. Down there is filled with nothing. This is the giant dead end. Alright, I think I know where I'm going. Oh, so, hey, guy! No! You stupid mongrel! There we go.
Where are you at now?
65, so two, so three more. Oh no! Wait, did I make a circle?
I don't know. You've been following the one wall.
And I think I'm this one. Yep, leveled up. Now I'm ready. Mainly because if I try to kill more gargoyles. Oh, I've been to this chest before. I'll find it. So this game has had a very unimpressive... No, A is the jump button, so Y is the item button. This game's been very unimpressive so far.
Yeah?
God, Kid Me was probably, like, the master of being patient. When it came to these types of games, just... We're gonna go through the cave! Alright. Oh, no, that's the way to the top floor. We don't want to go there. I just kind of find things at random.
Yeah.
Okay, I guess you gotta wander a bit more.
We could squeeze in Pokemon after this if we wanted to.
Sure. I don't have to be at work till 4. Alright! Wow, this might actually take less than an hour to finish. How long have we been going?
Less than an hour, I think.
Yeah, so this
is
actually...
probably be a little over an hour video, this, if we stop after this cave. So yes, I'm saying a cave would take like just about an hour.
Okay.
Isn't that how long you said it took you when you were young?
It took me an hour to like actually figure out what the fuck I was supposed to do in the town.
Okay. Not to actually beat the boss.
No. It depends on whether or not I'm, Okay, so Samson. What do you think Samson is?
I don't know. I play Binding of Isaac, so I can't expect anything.
Okay, I got my shiny stone, but
is he a beholder?
I need to equip the key. Sorry. At least the menus look pretty. Oh.
Yeah.
Samson!
Okay, so he's a knight.
He's a
giant knight.
He's giant. He's huge. Nothing bigger. Alright, let's fight.
I take it that stuns you in place when he does the stomp?
Kind of. What? Wow! Samson, why?
So his knee is his weakness. There you go.
Okay, this is where the... I can't use the item! Why not?
Dead.
Game over.
I guess size is everything. And now you have to go through the cave. No, you don't. Okay, good.
So the fact that he's so huge, and that your hitbox with the weapon is just so small, and you can't really aim it when you're facing upwards, that kind of bites you in the ass.
So this game has become Dark Souls. For at least one boss.
You kidding me? This game was already Dark Souls. I beat this guy somehow. He does deal a lot of damage to you, so... Oh, wow!
Just whack it. He's not moving.
Yeah, I sunlocked him. Come on! Please don't tell me I gotta grind some more. Oh, thank you for backing off, Samson.
That was nice. So, the item's still not working? You still have the key equipped.
Yeah, and I'm not dealing a whole lot of damage. So, am I just...
Man, if only you had an actual sword.
If only I had a sword that, like, you know, swung from left to right or something.
I don't know, you're still 50 gargoyles away from the next level.
God, do I want to do that? I might have to.
You think there's just no hope as you are now?
I know I got lost a lot the first time I played this.
If only there was like some warning of when he was gonna attack or something.
Yeah.
Like you're doing too little damage to use a hit and run strategy. That'd take forever.
Yeah. Can you not? Oh my god. Oh, there we go.
Like LRR.
Yes! There. I'm behind you. No. No! No! No!
Did he just trap you?
He just jumped upward to try
to
kill me.
Landed on you.
Yes! You died! Gold cave. Alright, so...
I mean, now that you know the item button...
Yeah.
Did you see if the shiny stone is a healing item?
Yeah, I will. I might have to grind some more. Fuck! Don't want to do it on stream. Hey guy. Ow!
You're planning for this to be a game that you do grinding off stream on?
I guess I'll have to do it on stream if, it's fine, I'm ahead of schedule.
Wow.
Shining Stone did jack shit.
Maybe it. You have MP. Maybe it's an MP recovery.
That would make sense. All right. Fuck it. How many gargoyles?
50.
Better start grinding. Samson.
Now we're playing this on my computer, obviously, since we're on my stream.
Yeah.
We talked about this before the stream, was that apparently you can change your name on Twitch now.
Oh, really?
So I'm, yeah, that's what has
been
said.
Oh yeah, you mentioned this before.
So I'm considering whether it might be a good idea to change my Twitch to just the Fourth Seat Studios, and we just both use this channel.
I mean, I wouldn't object to it.
Well, and then that way you could have your odds on your computer set up to it as well. And we never stream at the same time anyway, so.
Yeah, so. So I'm at 3 right now.
That way you could have, you know, your save file and everything. And if you wanted to, you could grind off camera.
Yeah.
Instead of, you know, me having your save file hostage on my computer.
I could just grab the save file and then,
That too.
I'll give it a few more. I'll level up and I'll give it a few more attempts. I think I can take this guy down. It's just that, So, here's the thing. If you're at a specific level, you would actually be dealing less damage than if you were, like, completely under-leveled.
Okay.
Yeah, this game's,
was
like...
Was level 13 unlucky or something?
No. Here's how it works. So, if you're, like, severely under-leveled, the game takes note of that and decides, well, you can't really deal any damage, but fuck it. You can deal 2 damage.
Yeah.
And that's not good, but it's better than nothing.
Whereas if you're just the right level, you'll only deal 1 damage?
Yes.
Okay, I see.
Because it uses the other one. Sometimes you'll deal 0 damage. You'll just be hitting him and nothing will happen.
Yeah. So you're just weak enough that you can't damage the boss, but just strong enough that the game doesn't pity you.
Yes.
Sounds like a win-win scenario.
Okay,
make more tea.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm going to be recording after you go to work today.
Oh, what are you doing? Oh, you're doing,
audiobook.
Audiobook. I thought you were doing, the character I couldn't do.
No, he's taken care of.
Oh, he is? You did it?
Yeah.
When?
Like a week and a half ago.
Oh. But you just wanted to give me the opportunity to try?
No, I did it, like, as soon as after you did it.
Okay.
After we tried to do it with you.
Okay, fair enough. I just can't do deep Russian, I guess. At least the spawns are like... At least with this game, you don't have to just wander around finding random encounters. You just kind of know where they spawn and then just kill them.
Yeah. If only there was a dedicated... That'd be a dick move if a game had a dedicated grind room. Like, it knew you were gonna be too weak, so it had a room set aside with, like, a bunch of enemy spawns.
Yeah,
you have fun, asshole!
They would just call it the challenge room or something. God. Strength 36, defense 33. And... So we literally encounter, like, a creature called Jesus, and it's just, like, this Hydra.
Yeah?
I'm speculating at this point. Fake speculating. Alright, come on. I'm almost there! Yep. Can you imagine, like, the hero, like, can't beat him, so he's like, oh, I gotta train somewhere, he just kills a bunch of demons.
Yeah. They never had to grind in Slayers.
No.
I can't think of any series where grinding was a thing, even in series that are, like, actual video games, like Dot Hack Sign.
Oh, no, Dot Hack Legend of the Twilight.
Oh, where, yeah, they did.
Where it's like, what's his name, Shugo?
Pathetic.
Shugo can't, like, control his, like, bracelet, so he's like, let's get you trained, so... it basically is just him swinging his swords at nothing while the other guys do heavy lifting.
Oh, yeah, that was it. I think that also happened in Sign, where Sora was... Not Sora. The main character.
Tsukasa.
They decided that he was underleveled, and so he went to, you know, train.
Yeah. Because he can't actually die and leave the world. He has to just kind of stay there. You know what's funny? I played the first Dot Hack video game.
Yeah.
Dot Hack, like, Infection. Yeah. And the thing with that game was that if you died, that was it. It was game over.
Yeah.
And for many other players, that wasn't the case. It was only for your character. Which, you know, made sense because of, like, the shit that was going on in that game.
Yeah.
Should have fought the skeletons some more. But I don't want to leave because if I leave, I'm not going to be back here for, like, 20 minutes.
What, you can't go to the next floor and then come back?
I don't know. It's all the way back to the other, side, and I would kill enough gargoyles that going there would probably be pointless.
Where you at?
236 out of 280. What's a lagoon anyway?
It's a body of water.
What type of body? How's that different from a lake?
A lagoon sounds more tropical, I guess.
the tropical world of lagoon.
Yeah.
Of Lakeland. So we got a world called Lakeland.
I'm sure there's a minute difference in, like, definition. I've never looked them up. I would do so now, but I think, unlike the PlayStation emulator, this one stops if you defocus the window.
No, you're right. It does. And I can't control it if you defocus the window. Lagoon.
I guess this would also be kind of nice if we were on your computer, because then we could use mine to look up stuff and monitor the chat.
Yeah, that's true. We are monitoring the chat, by the way.
I know.
It's up here. We see it. This is that nobody's saying anything because they're too enraptured by the awe of the beauty that is Lagoon.
We could also do that if you had your computer out here, you lazy fuck. Currently having lemon ginger tea.
Lemon ginger tea, best tea. So for anybody who's watching this, I apologize about the length of the grinding. I want to beat him, but I can't with where I am at right now. I need to be stronger.
And on Jack's behalf, I apologize that we're playing this game.
Don't apologize for playing this game. I was going to get around to it eventually.
I know.
This is a game that needs to be conquered. By the way, the final boss of this game has like a 5-form fight.
So did you ever beat this game as a kid?
Oh, I think so. I got to the final, I got through most of the game. I think I stopped at like the final boss or something. Either I beat the game or I stopped at the final boss. Or I watched a TAS and I didn't realize it. I don't know. 60, so I got 20 more to go. Or
so Metal Gear Solid.
Did we explain that on stream?
Oh god, oh, I guess
we might have been
waiting. We were going to explain it when we got to it, but since that's like far back on our backlog, we might as well.
Yeah, I don't know if we'll get to Metal Gear at anytime soon.
We'll get to it.
Yeah.
So,
we did play through the game on disc on PlayStation 1 off stream.
By ourselves.
Yes.
This is before we decided to take up streaming.
Yeah.
And we were doing pretty well.
We got all the way to the end. Had a lot of funny moments that would have been great recorded.
Yeah. And then we got to the Liquid Snake going into the Metal Gear, and the game just wouldn't go past that damn cutscene. It stopped
froze.
There.
It just stopped.
It was like
freezing as he was reaching for the, you know, the igniter to get into the mech.
Or like to start it, and it just wouldn't start. So we stopped, and
it just, every time we rebooted it, it would stop and freeze at exactly that point. Whatever was wrong with the disc.
Yeah, he couldn't get Metal Gear Rex started.
Yeah, that was our joke. He's just like, hold on, Snake, they're just stalling a bit. I'll kick your ass in a minute.
And wasn't there like a fucking airstrike that was coming there too? All Snake had to do was just walk away.
So we decided that was the end, is that he never got the mech started and the secret agents all showed up and Liquid got arrested and that was that.
Yeah.
He just walked off, never activating his ultimate weapon.
And then the plot of the next few games is radically different because of that. Because he couldn't start up Metal Gear Rex. You know what's funny?
What?
That game didn't end with the final boss battle wasn't Metal Gear Rex either. The final boss battle was Snake and Liquid having a fist fight.
Yeah.
I'm disappointed that we stopped where we did, because...
Not that we had much choice.
Yeah.
Like, we could...
Alright,
we have a PlayStation 1 emulator, so we could always do that next time.
We'll have to see how it interacts with the emulator. If it's too laggy, that might be a problem.
Yeah.
But if it works fine, then I have no problem doing it again.
We had some minor problems with Spyro, but it wasn't nearly as bad as Banjo.
Yeah. No, Banjo is by far the worst.
Unfortunately.
Sadly. Tooie is a great game, though. Banjo Tooie. I want to get through Kazooie, because Tooie's a superior game. Anyway. Alright, Samson.
So I guess we're either waiting until the N64 technology improves.
See? Look at how much better that shit is!
Yeah. Or I guess until we acquire a hard copy. Oh, he's an eyeball now.
We were also thinking about getting Twin Snakes.
No, I was talking about Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh. Okay.
And Twin Snakes is also an option if we can find that.
You reckon that's a sound effect?
No.
That's the elephant sound effect from Dalsum Stage in Street Fighter 2. So you kill...
Okay.
Every boss has that elephant death roar, even human enemies.
Okay. I never played Street Fighter 2, so I'll take your word for it.
You defeated Samson. What do we get? We got the Fire Crystal!
Now we can evolve our Vulpix.
Oh, we can actually go back.
And now he's back. We gotta fight him again.
That would be so bullshit. I never actually went back to Atland after killing him.
Yeah? Well, you want to see what the dialogue's like?
Probably unchanged.
So you have to go through this cave to the other side to get to the next area?
Yes.
Okay. You really want to go all the way through the cave again?
No, I don't.
Let's just move on.
Let's move on. Okay, so... So this, So we shouldn't have actually killed this boss if we wanted to stay where we were. Because... Cave-in! Oh no! The entrance of the cave was buried by the earthquake! Not a earthquake, the earthquake!
So in other words, we couldn't be bothered to update the dialogue for this town. So you can't go there again.
I can't go back now!
If you leave the forest, you'll never be able to return!
New enemies! Spiders.
And they stack. Wow, they have a lot of hit points.
Yeah. Welcome to Elf Field.
We have spiders.
Oh my god. So, this is when this game starts getting ridiculously hard.
Yeah.
Like, I remember as a kid, like, okay, the Gold Cave was one beast, and that was, you know, okay. But then I got to, like, the next,
Everywhere looks the fucking same. It's just grass and trees.
Yeah! It's a field! What were you expecting?
Landmarks?
Landmarks? You fucking kidding me, bro?
I don't know. Patterns of trees, little cliffs or something. There's something. Maybe deviations in the grass.
Okay. There, I'm gonna. All right. So there are two places we can go. There's a village filled with elves, and then a castle. We're gonna go to the castle first.
Okay. Phillips. I love those guys.
All right. So here's why jumping is in this game.
Have projectile enemies?
So, you know how in Zelda there's pits?
Yeah.
And they deal, like, a half-hearted damage if you fall in.
Wait, are there?
Yeah, Zelda...
Oh, yeah, in the dungeons. I know what you're talking about.
Here's a pit.
Is it instant death?
Yes!
Instant game over!
See, so you see this pit, you're like, oh, this is just broken bridge. Well, let's try to pass it. Oh! Game over.
That's very dramatic.
Yeah.
CD Player Castle.
So this game has platforming elements.
Yeah.
One really dick level, like, later on has that kind of shit too. So here's Phillip's Castle, and Phillip's Castle is subject to a curse.
Okay.
Like, every so often, like, the castle will just fall asleep.
Okay.
So...
Tablet of Hope.
So every 1,000 years, I believe. So we gotta get 3 tablets and then wake the sumbitch up.
So we have to, Oh, fuck, what was the name of the city? Save Taparashia.
Taparashia, except it's just a castle, and no one important actually dwells here. Like, the elves are aware of this castle, and they just kind
of... Well, yeah, of course. Bakota's off making magical tanks. Of course he wouldn't be here.
So we can't actually enter until we break the spell, and we have to break the spell and go in because there's some elves trapped in here.
Oh.
And then here's another door. This door will become important later.
Okay. That's the back entrance to Bowser's castle.
Also, the water kind of looks muddy now. Towards, like, the rocks.
A little, I guess.
I guess it could just be the reflection. Alright, time to actually go meet the elves. And, I guess, upgrade our equipment, maybe. Maybe we'll get a bow.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. Ranged combat in this game. Anything to, like, you know, not use this thing.
Yeah.
Not use our gladius.
Our kitchen knife. An RPG hero wielding the preferred weapon of scream.
Dude. Okay, here's an RPG that I'm surprised nobody ever thought of. Like, you get all the horror icons together, yeah. And they're just all the protagonists, and they fight, like, demons or something.
So you have an RPG party of horror characters?
Yeah, Jason Voorhees can be the protagonist.
I guess.
He's silent.
Because he's the fighter.
Philip's castle is at the east side of the village. I know everything about the castle. A legend says that that every 1,000 years when sunlight hits the castle, it is put to sleep for 1 year.
So who else would be in it? We got Freddy Krueger, he speaks. He's got the claws.
He can be the mage.
Assassin,
sure.
Because there's like dagger dual wielding.
Michael Myers.
He's got like, what does he got? He also just has a knife.
Scream would be the comic relief.
Yeah. Slenderman could be the mage.
He's not a slasher villain, though.
No, it didn't say slasher villain. It just said horror icons.
Fair enough. The three tablets which can break this sleep are scattered around this village. Fortunately, the castle was put to sleep with our friends trapped inside. I can read the spell.
The grudge is the love interest.
The grudge!
Or Sadako.
Or Samara.
The grudge wasn't the name of an actual character, was it?
No, it was the American term for it.
Yeah.
Or the movie in Japan was called J-On the Grudge. Mm. J-On. I think the grudge is a boy.
Oh.
Maybe.
There were like three grudge movies.
Yeah. And one called The Ring versus The Grudge.
Yeah.
According to what I've learned, one tablet hidden on this plane is in the plane, the other is in the castle site. A man in blue had the last tablet. Alright.
They look like garden gnomes.
They're elves!
I know.
We'll get to the gnomes later! Philip's castle is no longer what it used to be.
Used to manufacture A-tracks.
Nice. I heard demons control the castle now. Alright, what do we... A weapon shop!
Hey, Linkle.
We can get a healing pot, shiny ball... Are you fucking serious?! You're selling shiny ball for that much?!
It's valuable shit.
This is a rip-off.
But if you get a shiny ball voucher, then you can get one for free.
I'm sorry, I have nothing you need. A thief took everything the other day.
He looks like the pissed off Kakiri.
Yeah! Was it Mido?
Mido? That was it, yeah.
Mido's like, a thief stole everything, I can't sell... Damn it. No bows. Alright. This is the village of elves. This is not a place for human beings.
Racist.
Racist elves. Glad to see that's still a thing. I saw the guy in the corner. I'll be right down. The right door of Philip's castle has been locked, so we cannot get to Dinagul.
You have to go through a castle to get to town?
To get to another town. I wonder how we can open it. I'll worry about that. Okay, so here's this guy.
Old Gowrie.
Thor!
Okay.
Thor, God of Thunder!
I travel alone and visit many villages, so I have things, many rare items.
Look at his sprite, though. He looks like old, decrepit Gowrie.
Thor's actually a really important character, but he doesn't start off like it.
Oh.
Decrepit Gowrie. He's actually supposed to be as old as Nasir.
Oh. Well, his sprite looks hunched over.
Yeah. All right. Where's the fucking... Hey, do you know where the mayor is? Some people went to Phillip's Castle because the water got muddy. What were they hoping to fix?
So last time it was demons. Now since we dealt with them and the water's still muddy, oh, it must be something in the castle. And then we're going to deal with the castle and it's still going to be muddy. And they're like, oh, it must be in this next town.
they're gonna eventually find, like, the pump system that's flooding the lake with shit and then shut it off. Oh, you must be the famous champion of the light.
Okay.
Will you?
No.
No. I see. That's too bad. The conversation over. But we can just come back in and say yes. Thank you. Hand this movable mantle to our friends caught in Phillip's castle. You get movable mantle.
Okay. Is this supposed to be a wig?
No, it's a cape.
Okay.
And I'll give you this earth staff. You can use it well, but there are some places where you can't use magic, so be careful.
It's only programmed in certain maps.
So we get the Earth Staff. So here's how magic works in this game. You get a crystal and you get a staff. Crystal determines element and staff determines power level. So Earth Staff is the weakest. And we combine the two and we get Fireball.
Okay, it's a unique system.
Yeah, it's pretty okay. Magic goes from being kind of useful to holy shit later on.
So like Skyrim.
Not exactly like Skyrim, because all the spells do is just... There's no healing spells in this game.
Alright.
No utility spells. Oh, wait, hold on. I forgot. I need to talk to Thor again.
Volo.
Hey, Thor! What's shaking? Do you want to get into Phillip's castle? Yeah. About the talents, I got one of them. If you want to look for the other one, I'll help you. I am Thor! We can be good friends. Tablet of Faith.
So you have two of the three now.
Yes. And now he's going to take us to the third one. He's just going to kind of follow us. If he feels like it. Now he gets to the field, and we just kind of... Now he says that, but really we just follow him. Now, magic. You hit R and you fire fireballs.
Oh, good, your MP regenerates, too.
Yeah. That's a great sound effect.
Yeah.
So, yeah, magic is going to be our crutch for the next few levels.
Yeah, it took them, like, 6 or 7 sword hits. Takes them 2 magic blasts.
Oh, no, I missed. So...
2 for spiders, 1 for flies.
Lena Inverse, this guy is not.
Well, no, you're the one casting fireballs.
Yeah. No, I mean me. I mean Nasir.
Oh, yeah.
Look! What's a tablet doing here? Tablet of wish.
He sounded surprised.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess he did find it.
So are we done? Let's take the tablet to the old man now. Why? We need to just...
You just had to go to the castle.
But he knows everything about the castle. We show him the tablets, so he'll show us how to get into the castle.
Oh, okay.
Because it's not just tablets. You can just show him to the castle, and then he'll just wake up.
One does not simply walk into Phillip's castle.
Phillip's castle. Not named for anybody, just Phillip's. They say that the reign of King Phillip was ended after the CDI failed.
Yeah.
What? Thor, where are you? Thor!
Sorry, I got stuck on a tree.
God damn it, Thor.
This tree is fascinating.
Fascinating tree. I feel like we're gonna walk around here and eventually we're gonna stumble upon Maxwell from Don't Starve.
Yeah.
Alright. Back in Bolo. Oh, you found it! The spell is Higle La Mera Kamule.
Okay.
We made it, Nasir. I have something to take care of. I'm leaving now. So long. He's gone. So if you're in town, your health and magic recovers quicker.
I have to go fight Loki.
So Thor, in case you didn't realize that Thor's actually a guy.
Yeah, I had assumed so.
I was kind of confused the first time I played this game.
Looked this like game, a very manly face to me.
This game introduced me to the concept of androgyny.
He looked like Kalua's dad.
Kalua's... Oh, you
the
mean...
The Warrior Vice.
Oh my god, yeah. A family that was oddly supportive of him,
yeah.
yet disagreed with his actions. Best family of assassins. What's my level at? Level 7. So I somehow gained 2 levels.
Just by blasting shit with fireballs.
Yeah. I think this is one of my favorite tracks in the game, though.
Yeah.
This is so... That's kind of a stretch, saying this is my favorite, considering that this game soundtrack is kind of,
generic?
Yeah. Okay. May the gods hear our wish! Please wake up the door of hope from his deep sleep! Hilik Lemira Kamuli!
So I'm guessing this is the second dungeon.
Yeah. Here. I'll go into it for a little bit. I'm just showing off. So. This game kind of, dungeon kind of changes things up, but no, I'm just kidding. It just, this, oh!
Is he immune?
Knights are immune to fireballs, because they got the armor.
Okay.
So, we
but
get fireball magic,
swords.
And it's immediately useless. Thank you, game! Alright, fuck, I don't know where to go.
Immune to fireballs, not immune to knives.
So, if you know what you're doing, this game kind of goes by quickly. The only major choke points are the bosses.
But this is a dungeon, so it's a maze, so it'll probably take a little while.
You want to stop here?
Yeah.
Alright, let's... We'll save this for... Hey! Knight! I'll kill this one guy, and then we'll go. What? So, 418,
he's
and
still
then if
alive.
I kill this guy... 423. Leveling up should be easier here.
Yeah, 5 per enemy.
Yeah. Well, I'll save here. Saving anywhere in this game is incredibly useful.
Yeah. It's nice that it's readily accessible, not save points or something.
Yeah. This game is very unfair in certain things, but it makes up for it by, you know, having passive healing and stuff.
It has some things going for it. Alright.
I think the bad outweighs the good in this situation, though, especially with combat being as piss poor as it is.
Yeah, the short sword is kind of a big hit.
Yeah.
All right. Almost wish you what makes you wish you were compensating for something.
I wish I had the Cloud Buster sword. I would be able to hit shit, man.
All right, we'll be right back with a shorter Pokemon stream.
Yeah, well, I'll get back to this eventually.